In this video, we'll try to understand how to find out point of contraflexure in case of simply supported beam having overhang on the left hand side. Now let us see first the problem statement. We have to draw shear force and bending moment diagram for the arrangement of the simply supported beam as shown in the figure, and also find point of contraflexure if any. So first step is that we have to find out the values of RA and RB, that is reactions at A and reaction at B. Now we'll apply the conditions of equilibrium over here. So the first condition of equilibrium that is present will be the summation of forces in y direction is equal to zero. Before that, we'll try to understand the meaning of these arrows that we have provided. So RA reaction RB will produce the anti-clockwise moment if you take it about A. This 50 kN will produce a clockwise moment, and this 30 kN will produce the anti-clockwise moment. The first condition of equilibrium that will apply over here is summation of forces in y direction is equal to zero, considering upward forces positive and downward forces negative. So RA and RB, they are acting in the upward direction, whereas 30 kN and 50 kN, they are acting in the downward direction, so they are negative. So RA plus RB minus AT is equal to zero, or we can say that RA plus RB is equal to AT, and let us call this as our equation number 1. Now we have to take moment about point A is equal to zero, considering the conventions clockwise positive and anti-clockwise negative. As we have already seen, this RB will produce anti-clockwise moment. The arrow of this reaction RB will produce anti-clockwise moment. This 50 kN will produce clockwise moment about A, and 30 kN will produce anti-clockwise moment about A. Clockwise moments, they are positive, and anti-clockwise moments, they are negative. So RB, and from B up to A, perpendicular distance is 5. So minus RB into 5, negative sign, because it is anti-clockwise moment, and moment is equal to force into perpendicular distance. This 50 kN, the distance between T and A is 3. So 50 into 3, and that is clockwise moment, and therefore it is positive. 30 into 1, the distance between C and A is 1, but it is anti-clockwise moment, so it is negative. So 30 into 1 will produce the anti-clockwise moment, and hence it is negative. Now 15 into 3, that is 120, minus 30, that is 15 into 3, that is 150, minus 30, that is 120. Transfer this 5RB, minus 5RB on the other side, it will become plus 5RB. So 120 divided by 5 is the value of RB, and the value of RB comes out to be 24 kN. Now we can substitute that value of RB in equation 1. So equation 1 is RA plus RB is equal to AT, or we can say that RA is equal to AT minus RB. Now substitute the value of RB. RB is 24, so we can say that value of RA is 56 kN. Now using these values, we have to draw shear force and bending moment diagram. So the conventions which we have used for shear force diagram, their upward forces are considered as positive, whereas downward forces, they are considered as negative. Start from point C. So shear force at point C is minus 30, because at C there is a downward acting load, and the downward forces, they are considered as negative. Now shear force just at the left of A. So between C and just left of A, that means we are not considering 56 kN. So without considering this upward acting force of RA, so shear force just at the left of A will be same as this minus 30 kN. Exactly at A, there will be an upward acting force of 56 kN, and that is positive. So 56 minus 30, that is 26. Shear force at D left. So D left, without considering this 50 kN force, there is no other force. So whatever is the shear force at point A, the same will take place at the left of the D. So it is 26 kN. But exactly at point D, there will be a downward acting force of 50 kN, that is minus 50. So 26 minus 50, that is minus 24 kN. Shear force at the left of the B, there is no other force acting between D and just left of the B, correct, without considering this RB. So whatever is the shear force at D, the same will happen over here. So that is minus 24 kN. But exactly at point B, there will be an upward acting force of 24 kilonewton. So it is minus 24 plus 24, that is 0. So using these values, we have to draw shear force and bending moment diagram. So at C it is minus 30, remains same. Then again increases to 26, remains same. Decreases to minus 24, remains same, and becomes 0 at the end point. And these are the various values of the shear forces at C, at A left, exactly at A, at D left, exactly at D, at B left, and exactly at B. So these are the various values which will be useful for us while drawing the shear force diagram. Now we have to draw the bending moment diagram. The conventions that we are using over here for drawing the bending moment diagram are clockwise positive and anti-clockwise moment negative. So these moments, these directions are shown over here purposely so that we can easily understand. The RA will produce clockwise moment about any point, that is D and B. This 30 kilonewton downward acting forces will downward acting force will produce anti-clockwise moment about A, D or B, correct, like that. So first we know that at the end points of simply supported beam, bending moment is always zero. So at point C, bending moment will be zero. At point B also, bending moment will be zero. Now first we'll find out the bending moment at A. Consider all the forces on the left hand side of A. So on the left hand side of A, there is only one force, that is 30 kilonewton, and it is producing anti-clockwise moment. So 30 into 1, the distance between C and A is 1 meter. So minus 30 into 1, negative sign, because it is anti-clockwise moment. Then bending moment at point D. So this is the point D. So 30 kilonewton force again will produce anti-clockwise moment about D. But now the distance between C and D is 1 plus 3, that is 4. So it is minus 30 into 4. This RA will produce clockwise moment about D. And the perpendicular distance between A and D is 3 meters. So RA into 3. Substitute the value of RA. RA is 56. So we can say that bending moment at point D is 48 kilonewton meter. Then bending moment at point B is 0. Even if you make the calculations, for example, if you want to find out bending moment at point B, consider all the forces on the left hand side of B. So 30 will produce the anti-clockwise moment. So 30 and perpendicular distance between C and B is 3 plus 2 plus 1, that is 6. Then RA will produce clockwise moment. So plus RA into 5. This 50 will produce anti-clockwise moment, so it is negative. So 50 into 2. If you make the addition, you will get bending moment as 0. So at the end points, always you will get the bending moment at 0. There is no need of calculation for this. Now we have to draw the bending moment diagram using these values. So you can see the bending moment at point A is minus 30, bending moment at point D is 48, and at the end points it is 0. But the bending moment diagram is changing its sign from negative to positive. And this point is known as the point of contraflexure, and we have to find out this particular point of contraflexure. So at this particular point of contraflexure, the bending moment is 0. So extrapolate this on our main diagram and consider this section xx at a distance x from the point C. So if this distance is x, then this distance is 1 meter, then this remaining distance will be x minus 1 meter. And now we have to find out this point of contraflexure using the same convention. So conventions that we are using over here are clockwise positive and anti-clockwise moments, they are considered as negative. Now consider all the forces which are present on the left hand side of this section xx. So on the left hand side of this section xx, we are having 30 kilonewton force which will produce anti-clockwise moment as indicated by this arrow. So it is negative. So it is minus 30 into x. Then this RA will produce clockwise moment. As you can see, this will produce clockwise moment about this section xx. So RA into x minus 1, that is positive because it is clockwise moment. And this bending moment at this section xx is 0, that we also know, correct. So this value is equal to 0. So minus 30x multiply by RA inside the bracket. So it is RA into x. RA into minus 1, that is minus RA. Now transfer this minus RA on the other side, so it will become plus. And now you can substitute the value of RA over here. So value of RA is 56. So 56x minus 30x, so that is 26x is equal to 56. Or we can say that x is equal to 56 upon 26. That is nothing but 2.1538 meter from C, or 2.154 meter from C. So in this way we can find out the point of contrafacture. So thank you very much for watching.